Welcome to the session on fragment and replicate join in the parallel databases. This is one of the interoperation technique. At the end of this session, you will be able to apply this fragment and replicate join on given relations. So, earlier we have seen some interoperation parallelism techniques like parallel sort operation, parallel join operation. In that, we have seen partition join also. So the videos are available for this one. Today we'll be talking about fragment and replicate join, which is one of the parallel join technique. So this fragment and replicate join basically used where non-equijoin conditions are there. For example, you can say that where partitioning is not possible for the semi-join conditions, that is equality conditions. Non-equijoin conditions, you may say the relation R with attribute A, which is greater than relation S attribute B, something like that. So the conditions which we are taking for comparison operator may be except, equal to, that is equijoin. So basically fragment and replicate join is most suitable for non-equijoin conditions. So the operations may be not equal to, greater than equal to, less than equal to, less than greater than, some of the things. So consider this example. The query is something like that: select name, mean price, maximum price, price, city, from person, joins with apartment on apartment ID not equal to person's apartment ID, and price between minimum price and maximum price. So this is one of the query example. Let us see that how this will be executed for fragment and replicate join. Later I will show you the example relations also. We'll understand better there. So for joins where partitioning is not applicable, sometimes what happens that everywhere for every join operation, partitions may not be applicable. Okay, but we want to do the parallelization in that one. So in that case, we are using fragment and replicate join. Okay, so fragment and replicate join is used for two things. One is for the non-equijoins, and another one where partitioning is not applicable, where we cannot do the partitioning. Now, this fragment and replicate join is having one special case also, which is called as asymmetric fragment and replicate join. Let us go ahead with the explanation about this one. There are few considerations here that one of the relations, say R, is partitioned. So what we are doing in the special cases, which we call it as a asymmetric fragment and replicate join. So in this one, one of the relation is partitioned and another relation is replicated. Therefore, it is called as fragmented replicate. So here say that R is partitioned, relation R and S we are taking. So relation R is partitioned and we can apply any partitioning technique on that one. And the other relation S is replicated. Okay, basically here what happens that if we have relation R and S, where R is having more number of tuples than S, then the bigger relation which is having large number of tuples is partitioned, and the smaller one which is containing less number of tuples, say S here, that is replicated. And what the processor PI locally is doing, as every processors are having their partition RI and the replicated version of relation called as S, so locally it is doing the join operation of RI with S. Let us see that in detail more later. So this is the depiction of fragment and replicate join. Basically there are two forms here. One is this is the special case, that is asymmetric fragment and replicate join, and this is the fragmented, actual fragment and replicate join. See here, in the first one, that is asymmetric fragment and replicate join, which is the special case we can see in this one, what will happen that one of the relations, say R, we have seen earlier that R is partitioned. So you can see the partitions here, that is R0, R1, R2, R3, like this. And the table, the relation S is replicated. So the same copy is given to processor P0, P1, P2 and P3. So now how these are joining, taking the join operation: R0 joins with S, R1 joins with S, R2 joins with S, R3 joins with S. So here what happens, every tuple of relation R is mapped with, every compared with every tuple of relation S using this one. Then too, we have done the parallelism here. Now another form is this one, the actual fragment and replicate join. What has been done in this one? That in this one, both the relations are partitioned actually. That is, you can see here that R0, R1, R2, R3. So these are partitioned. Even S0, S1, S2, S3, these are also partitioned. Okay. What is replicated here? See, in this line, you can see that horizontally if we are going for. So how the join operation is taking place? That is, P00 is doing the join operation of R0 with S0. P01 is doing the operation of R0 with S1. P02 is doing the join operation of R0 with S2, so on. So what will happen here? That R0 is replicated on every processor, whereas S is now fragmented. You can see here, partitioned. Similarly, at this side, what will happen? That processor P00 is doing the join operation of R0 and S0. Processor 10 is doing the join operation of R1 S0. Processor P20 is doing the join operation of R2 S0. So here what happens? S0 is replicated. And what is partition? That is relation R here. So these are the forms of the fragment and replicate join. Let us move ahead with some example. So the general case here, what we are doing is, it is reducing the size of the relations at each processor. The normal fragment and replicate join requires more number of processor. We have seen earlier also. How you can see here that the partitions are these many, but the processors are these one. Okay, let us see how many processors we require here. So what is the scenario? R is partitioned into n partitions. You can say R0, R1, Rn minus 1. S is partitioned into m partitions, S0, S1, Sm minus 1. So we have n partitions of R, m partitions of S, and we can apply any partitioning technique here. There might be, how many number of processors are required? M multiplied by n. Why? We have seen earlier. Okay, the number of processors requires are more, and we are labeling them like these one. What the PIJ processor is doing? It is taking the join operation of partition RI with partition SJ. Okay, and in this case, what happens? RI is replicated to PI0. Similarly, in the horizontally, we have seen that SI is replicated to these processors. Okay, and we can apply any joining technique for this one. Let us take an example here. These are the example relations. You can see there are two examples, the person relation and the apartment. We have two relations, and we have the same query taken on this one, and we want to do the join operation parallelly. You can see this is the data available, and this is the query. Earlier we have seen this query, that is, we want to select name, minimum price, maximum price. So name, minimum price and maximum price from this one, price and city from this relation. And what is the join condition? We want to do the join operation on person and apartment, on where apartment ID, okay, ID of this this one, okay, not equal to person's apartment ID. So this one, okay, where it is not matching, those one we want to get the data. And what should be another condition? And the price should be between minimum price to and maximum price. Whatever minimum and maximum is there, that price we have to get the data from these one. Okay, so let us see the example with both the techniques. So this is a symmetric fragment and replicate join. You can see here that the table I have listed here to show you properly. So this is my table, this table, person table I have taken here, and this is the apartment table. And what we have done here, person table I have divided with two partitions. So the partitions are these one. You can see this is partition 0 and this is partition 1. Whereas the replication of apartment relation is this one. So this particular table is replicated at P0 also, and it is replicated at P1 also. Okay. And now what P0 is doing? P0 is parallelly doing the join operation of partition P0, partition of this particular person data with the replicated data of apartment. Similarly, persons and other partition parallelly is doing the join operation with the, again, apartment relation. Why? Because apartment relation is copied, you can say replicated. So that is what a symmetric fragment and replicate join is. Let us go ahead with another technique, the actual fragment and replicate join. For your purpose, I have done like this. So this is my person table, which is fragmented in two partitions, partition 0 and partition 1 of person relation. Similarly, the relation which is apartment, I have taken into two partitions. So this is partition P0 of apartment and partitioner P1 of apartment. And now what this processor will do, P00 is doing the join operation of partition 0 with partition 0 of this. Similarly, it is doing partition 0 of relation person with partition 1 of relation apartment. Similarly, here also it is doing the join operation of person, 0th partition of person with the 0th partition of apartment, similarly here also. So automatically what happens, all the every tuples of one relation are mapped compared with another relation, but parallelly every processor is working here. All these processors, that is processor P00, P01, P10, P11, all these are parallelly working. So again the same scenario, we have two relations, we have the query. Pause the video and try to write the result of this query. So let us see what will be the result. The result is like this. You can see that the data, the person ID, which is not matching with this one, okay, apartment ID and this ID, we have seen that apartment's ID not equal to person's apartment ID. So those data we have taken here. And again another condition is what, minimum price and maximum price. The price should be between 40,000 to this one. You can see for NA, okay, what is the apartment ID? 2. So we are not taking the apartment ID 2 for NA, we are taking the other apartment data. So for 1, if we are matching, we will see that the price is 30,000, which is in between the minimum and maximum. So we will get this data here. You can see that that data come here. 2 will not come because it is matching. 3, for 3 we can say that it is, the condition is what, the condition is this one. So it will come down here again, okay. So like this it works. So what we can say for fragment and replicate join, both the versions are working. For every tuple of R is mapped with every tuple of S, okay. It is having higher cost because you can see that the partitioning is also there, the replication is also there. So basically it is having higher cost, but more parallelism is implemented in this one, okay. But usually the asymmetric fragment and replicate is preferable. These are my references. Thank you.